Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest model bus review video. This one is the second Irish model bus that I have, although this one is a Northern Irish model bus. This one is the Leyland Tiger Cub with the Saro bodywork, and just to bring your attention to the details, the reference number is 76SB005, and this is a brand new 2020 release. This one is in the Ulster Transport Authority, so this is one of the few Northern Irish model buses that I have, and I do like the livery on this one, as I think it is a great model, and I wanted to get this one as soon as I found out that Oxford announced this one. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to pause the video momentarily whilst I remove all of the packaging. I've now unpacked this model bus and I have removed the tape strap that was attached the model to the stand for some odd reason. Although, to be honest, I don't feel it's really necessary to do that, as the two bolts that hold the model to the stand tend to hold the model into place quite reasonably well anyways. Next thing to do, just going to turn the turntable around so that the model is dead on facing the camera, and starting off with the destination blind. This one is on 1082 Alder Grove, and just to pan the camera down, this is definitely a Leyland Tiger Cub, as noted by the badge, and the registration is PZ4874, and you may have noticed that the Northern Ireland and the Hong Kong license plates are very much similar, although here in Northern Ireland we do have three letters and four numbers, as where in Hong Kong it's just two letters and four numbers, just for anyone that's interested. The model does have glazed headlights and flush glazing, so that's good. The only downside to this fantastic model is there is no wing mirrors. But I will still give this a great score at the end of the review anyways. So I'm just going to put the camera back into its original position. And I'm just going to zoom out a wee bit. The detail very much speaks for itself. And without further ado, let's commence on with a 360 degree rotation then, shall we? Just going to adjust the camera and zoom out a wee bit more, just to avoid any cropping of the model as I turn the turntable around. I do like this livery, and I may repaint a couple of buses for the OMSI2 bus simulator into this livery as well, as I do like to do things differently. But sticking to the model is very nice for detail. The wheels are freewheeling, and this model is in the 176 scale, so you could put this on your model railway if you model the railways of Northern Ireland of this period. Or this model bus would be a great addition to your model bus fleet if Irish buses interest you, like they do me. And just bringing the bus back to its final position, and of course adjusting the camera accordingly. I'm going to give this one a 9 out of 10, as if the model had wing mirrors I would have given this a perfect 10, but I think a 9 out of 10 is a very fair and a justified score, as these models are quite good value for money. for the detail that these buses do have, as the Oxford diecast range I consider is very good value for money. Some do have extensive detail, as where other models do have very basic detail, depending on the model vehicle you are seeking in particular. But I think a 9 out of 10 is a fair and justified score. Anyways, that concludes my review. Thank you for watching. As always, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback on the content I create. Until next time, have a good week or weekend. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care, and cheerio. All the best, and God bless. Thank you.